My eyes are not red because I'm high. It's because I have not slept in the last 36 hours. Your boy pulled an all-nighter last night just to go into the Esports World Cup today. It has been a crazy set of matches in the last, 5 hours that we've had these games going on. And sadly, some big upsets, big teams eliminated, and now we'll be going home. And some, unfortunately, I think are now due for some roster changes. We're going to talk about all of this today and especially talk about which teams are looking to win this bad boy literally just tomorrow. So starting off with Group B, Alliance going into the finals, obviously. EXO, Elevate, don't forget this is the Bleed / Elevate collaboration they're doing. Mizuchi, which is the Not Moist Esports, Blacklist International, Dragon, LGD, Fnatic, and DMS. Don't forget, this is not the top 10 going on to the next bracket. It is the top 9 because the bottom 11 have different implications. So the 10th place through 19th, that's Virtus Pro, TSM, Weibo Gaming, Navi, NRG, HAO, Northception, TIE, Space Station, and Heroes went on to the last chance qualifier. Riddle Esports, sadly, was eliminated. So that means Riddle Esports, Reject, Winity, all eliminated from here. Then you go into last chance today. Honestly, not the bracket that, or not the point system I thought I would see. I love this though. Guild Esports with MZ, right? MZ leaves North America. Everybody's worried about him. Is he still committed? Is he still in it? He said he was like having some issues. He goes back to play for APAC South. Are they going to be good enough? Oh boy, yes, they are. They did a great, phenomenal job inside of LCQ today, or inside of the last chance here bracket. Guild Esports moves on in first place. And the way this one is set up, it is weird. So we had to say goodbye to many teams. So your top 9 from Group A went to the finals. Your top 9 from Group B went to the finals. That's 18. So that means the last chance, ALGS style, has the top 10 go, right? Well, this one's not the case. Only the top 2 go. So Guild Esports and Space Station were able to get top 2 after the 10 games were over. They will be joining the finals with all the other teams we just mentioned. Sadly, that means third place, right? TSM, they're going home. Even though third place is good, right? It's definitely a top 3 podium finish inside of a bracket play is good, but sadly the way the format is, it's not good enough, so they will be going home. Also, what's weird is when you take a look at this, TSM actually scored 130 points over the collective 2 days, and Space Station only scored 126 points over the collective 2 days, but yet Space Station gets to go in, TSM does not. I just personally think two teams inside of the way that the loser bracket is not personally enough. But I do kind of like at the same time that, you're not going into it with the same implications. Like, hey, you need to really win. You cannot afford to go. There's a big disadvantage, right, in going into the losers. You have to really, really earn that bad boy. And so I get it. TSM in third. Sadly, we'll be saying goodbye. Northception in fourth. Fennel in fifth. Virtus Pro in sixth. Honestly, Virtus Pro playing a lot better than what they were inside of Split 2. So, I guess a little bit of a round of applause. Sadly, still not enough. HAO disguised in eighth place. Not a bad, not a bad performance, but this is not going to be enough to keep this roster going, in my opinion. Eighth place for them. NRG showed some signs of life, right? They had a first place. They had a fourth place, but just not enough in the end. Red Rams, NIP, sadly, slow start again. They did get a win in there, a third place in there, but just not enough at the end of the day. Navi, Makers, Heroes, Geeke, Pioneers, first land for a lot of these guys. And it was nice to see them make it into, the LAN itself. And I was happy to see them there. I was happy to see them go into Split 2 playoffs. And obviously, we got Germany just around the corner. I'm glad to see their name in this. I'm just sad that it wasn't better than what it should have been. They started off really good, right? Third place on their first. I know they were happy with that. And it just got worse and worse and worse. And you'll see Crazy Raccoon started the day off with a win. And I was like, dang, like, here we go. This team is here to play. And no, it just got worse and worse. A lot of 20th, a lot of 19th here. And the way that it is, I've been basically hearing from all the pros involved, they personally prefer the drafts. They are not really about this old style contesting stuff. I remember all the drama that came out when the draft first came out is that we don't want this. This is not the way it should be done. And now it seems like they have definitely flopped. They love the draft. Draft seems to be more, consistent. Evo's Predator, Ty, and Weibo in the bottom. So those guys also eliminated. So that means your finals is now very clear, right? You've got Guild, you've got Space Station, you've got Alliance, EXO, E8, Mizuchi, Blacklist, Dragons, LGD, Fnatic, DMS, and obviously your Falcons, Twisted Minds, Liquid, FaZe Clan, Gaming Gladiators, Luminosity, Aurora, GHS, and EXL. Personally, if I had to take a guess, I do think that Falcons are going to win this finals tomorrow. No doubt about it whatsoever. I also think that you're going to see a lot of, I think Twisted Minds will make a top five finish. I do think that Space Station will be a team to be reckoned with still, even though they're coming out of Last Chance. Don't count them out. I think Guild, I honestly, as much as I love the team, I think they played great today. I don't know. I don't think that's going to happen tomorrow, if I'm being honest with you. And as much as I would like it to, I just don't think it will. I'm hoping that Alliance will show us some signs of life. Not sure if that's going to happen when you have a stacked lobby with Falcons and such in it. But Elevate also is a team, obviously, I've been rooting for. You guys know that. And I like to see their progression, Zach specifically. But I don't know if they're going to be able to keep this level of momentum going into the next day. And obviously, Finals, a big day tomorrow. A lot of big teams here. A lot to prove here. But I do think we all kind of predict Team Falcons should more than likely take this. And if, and I mean it is a big if you do not see the Falcon, anybody else but the Falcons are an underdog. So if you don't see the Falcons win, then it is a big underdog moment for absolutely whoever. There's no, like, you know, most esports, right? It's like, I could see Falcons, I could see that. No, I don't think anybody's predicting that. We all are pretty confident Falcons should win this tournament. That should be the simple case. That should be the fact of the matter. Many people are saying, you know, Zero was not really putting in his normal, I guess, Zero type dominance. And so maybe you do see a different side to them. Maybe things are not going to be as consistent for them. I just don't think it's going to happen. I think they show up when times are important. They show up when it matters. And I think that's exactly the performance that you're going to get from Falcons inside of a clutch moment like this. Now, as we do approach these finals, just wanted to make this clear really quick. The teams that basically did really well in their groups, they will be getting starting points with this match point format. Alliance will be starting with 9, Falcons starting with 9, EXO starting with 8, Twisted Mind starting with 8, Elevate, Liquid started with 7, FaZe and Mizuchi with 6, Blacklist Gaming Gladiators with 5, then you've got Dragon Luminosity with 4, Aurora LGD with 3, Fnatic GHS with 2, DMS and EXL with 1. Guild and obviously Space Station coming out with 0, considering they came out from the Last Chance qualifier. So this is basically similar to the ALGS style from last split, right before they did the draft picks. You have those match point bonuses coming out of the winner's bracket. You get gifted that for being better throughout the tournament. And I get it. I like it for the scenario that we're given. I still think, though, at the end of the day, long-term scenario, we just need to be with the POI drafts and get rid of the match point format that we were doing with the advancement points and such. You just get a better draft pick if you're going to be having that higher seed. So regardless of not the way this tournament is ran, and interested to see how this affects our games as well. And also, speaking of the South American teams, I think we've been giving a lot of love to EXL, but we definitely need to show props where props are due inside of the Group B as well with Dragons Esport, right? Sixth place. This is the former Geared Gaming roster, right? With Panic and with Zilliq as well. So I think these guys are underrated also. Everybody was talking about how well Sleep had performed yesterday, and some were saying Sleep is a guy that, while he might be South American, they think he's a top five roller player in any region on any given day, honestly. I think these guys are underrated. They are showing their worth. I think, honestly, now that they are boosting themselves back up, you're seeing these top teams. I am not under the impression that we need to keep ignoring South America. Do they need their pro league back? I don't know, but I do think that they are they're mistreated. I really do. I'm sorry, and maybe you guys disagree. Yes, I know that they were underperforming whenever they had their own region, and yes, I know that it was like a freebie for some of these players as well because the region was a lot less competitive, but you cannot look at these rosters now and tell me they are not worthy of mentioning here, that they are not competing at that high level. It's been consistent, right? Geared did this in split one playoffs. They won inside of the loser bracket and actually won that bracket round very confidently. They're doing the same. They're qualifying in Esports World Cup. They're not going the South American teams are making it to the finals. They're not going even to the losers bracket. These guys are really showing themselves very, very strong, very predominant, and we need to take them seriously again. Just my personal opinion. You guys may totally disagree, but I'm happy for these guys to say the least. Obviously some excitement and I guess some emotions expressed with this as well. Designful came out to say, played my heart out both days, no regrets, I'll be better next time. Koi with the excitement saying we go on for finals, let's go. Noko saying that was some of the easiest or easily some of the best Apex we have seen, and I can't wait to see finals. GG's to everyone. And NRG Nocturnal obviously saying tried our best, it's the end of our road in Riyadh, sorry to disappoint everyone. So obviously a lot of emotions attached here. All in all, interested to see what you guys are predicting for the finals tomorrow. Who will be our World Cup champion other than the Falcons? Will we actually have an upset at all? We're definitely wanting to see some of these South American teams like EXL show up. I would love to see a different region kind of have a dominant performance. but it's hard to predict anybody else other than the GOATed Trio right now. Let us know what your thoughts are down below. And until the next time, we'll see you all later, Gators.